Hello friends, this is Professor Umesh and you are watching Made Easy Solutions. Friends, up till now I have uploaded 10 videos on my YouTube channel. We had learned number systems in first 4 of them and conversion between number system in the next 4 videos. We had also learned various measuring units in digital electronics in the 9th video. From the last video, we had started a video lecture series based on number system arithmetic, in which we are going to learn addition, subtraction, division, multiplication of the numbers in various number systems. So in the same series, we had already learned binary and decimal addition in the last video. So today we are going to learn how to add numbers in octal number system and in hexadecimal numbers. So let's move forward and start our today's lecture.
So now let's start with octal addition. Now follow the same principle we have seen in binary addition and decimal addition. That means we will first perform 2-digit octal addition. So now here we will have the same formula. That means we will have an adder and we will add an addend into it. And we will get the result and we will call it as a sum. So now here again in octal number system, we have total 8 basic digits. So adder can be from 0 to 7 and addend can be from 0 to 7. That means total 8 power 2 is equal to 64 combinations are here. So I will just consider some examples. So let's have a adder. I have a 0 as an adder here and 1 as an addend over here. It will give me a sum of 1. Now here keep in mind that my sum should be a valid octal digit or valid octal number, and 1 is a valid octal number. Here the sum should not be 8 or 9 because 8 and 9 is not a valid octal digit. So let's check the next possibility. Here I have considered 2 as an adder and 5 as an addend. So here my sum will be 7 and 7 is a valid octal digit, so it is a valid sum. Now let's check the next possibility. Here my adder is 1 and addend is 6, so my sum will be 7. Again 7 is a valid octal digit, so 7 is a valid sum over here. Let's check the next possibility. Here I have considered 2 as adder and 4 as addend, so it will give me a sum of 6. 6 is also a valid octal digit, so it is a valid sum. It is not mandatory that every time a 2-digit addition will give you a valid octal sum. Sometimes the result is larger than 7. Then what you will do in such a case? Let's see on the next slide. So here we will consider 2-digit addition with carry. So here the formula we will follow is we will have an adder and we will added into it along with carry generated in previous operation, and finally I will get the result and I will call it as a sum. Now here I have a 3-digit addition, that is adder, addend and carry. So total possible combination will be 8 power 3, that is 512. So it is not possible for me to show all possibilities. So let's check with some possibilities which will cover all the 512 possibilities. So here we will start with first possibility. My adder is 0 and my addend is 2 and my carry is 0. So here 0 plus 2 will be 2 and 2 plus 0 will be 2. So my sum will be 2 over here, and 2 is a valid octal digit, so my sum is valid here. Let's check with next possibility. Here my adder is 3 and I have added 2 with 3 along with 1 as a carry. So it will give me a sum of 3 plus 2 is equal to 5 and 5 plus 1 is equal to 6. So 6 is again a valid octal digit, so my sum is valid here. Now let's check with next possibility. I have considered the adder as a 5 over here and the addend as a 7 over here, and the carry as a 1 over here. Now let's check what will be the sum over here. 5 plus 7 is equal to 12 plus 1 is equal to 13. we are getting 15 over here. How my friends, the sum I am getting is 5 plus 7 is equal to 12 plus 1 is equal to 13. 13 is also a valid octal number, but the sum I must get is equal to 15. How is this? Recall the principle of addition we have used in decimal number system. If these digits would have been decimal, then what I would have get? See over here, 5 plus 7 is equal to 12 plus 1 is equal to 13. So 13 is the valid decimal addition, not octal. Here we have these digits in octal number system. So what to do? First consider the principle of decimal addition. What we do over here? Here we consider 3 as a sum of this current addition and 1 as a carry. Why my friends? We actually subtract 10 from 13 to get the sum of this addition. Why? Because the sum is larger than the highest possible digit of the decimal number system, that is 9. Because I am adding digits and the sum I get must be a digit, not a number. Here 13 is a number. So what we do? We subtract base of that number system from the result to get the sum of the current addition. So here I have subtracted 10 from 13 to get the sum of this current addition. And as I have taken out 10 from this result, I will consider it as a carry. Now as I am moving this 10 into the next digit, it will be divided by 10, because in decimal number system every digit has a weight of powers of tens. The digit placed at LSD position has a weight of 10 power 0 is equal to 1. The unit placed at next to LSD has a weight of 10 power 1 is equal to 10. The unit placed at next to it has a weight of 10 power 2 is equal to 100. That means as we go in left direction, the weight of the digits increases in multiples of 10. So here I am taking out 10 from the result and passing this 10 to the next digit, and that's why I divide this 10 by 10, and the result we get as a 1, and we consider this 1 as a carry over here. And thus we consider this sum as a 13. That means 13 has 3 as a sum and 1 as a carry, which is forwarded to next digit addition. So similarly over here we have to subtract base from the result, because the result is larger than 7. 7 is the largest possible digit in octal number system, and we are getting the result more than 7. So that's why subtract 8 from the result. So here I am getting the result 13, and I will subtract 8 from the 13. So if I subtract 8 from 13, I will get 5. So I will consider 5 as a sum over here and 1 as a carry. Weight of this 1 is 8 now, because base of this number system is 8. So we will pass this carry to the next digit addition. So this is how we get 15 as a result over here. 5 is sum and 1 is the carry for next bit addition, and so on. Now let's check the next possibility. Here my adder is 6 and my addend is 1 and carry is 2. So let's add it. 6 plus 1 is equal to 7 plus 2 is equal to 9. Now here again 9 is larger than 7. So subtract 8 from 9. Whatever result I will get will be the sum of this addition, and we will consider 1 as a carry. So let's check. 1 1 is the sum over here. How? I have subtracted 8 from 9. So when I subtract 8 from 9, I will get result as a 1. So I will consider this 1 as a sum over here and 1 as a carry to the next digit addition. So this is how we perform octal addition. Let's practice with one more possibility. So here I have considered 7 as an adder and 7 as an addend, along with 3 as a carry. It will give me the sum of, can you tell me now? 7 plus 7 is equal to 14 plus 3 is equal to 17. Now here if I subtract 8 from 17, what I will get? I will get 9, which is again larger than 7. So better way, we will subtract multiples of 8. next multiple of 8 is 16. So subtract 16 from 17. What I will get? 1. So 1 will be the sum over here. And as I am subtracting next multiple of 8, I will take 2 as a carry over here. That means I have got the result 2, 1. 17 minus 16, 1 will be the sum of this addition and 2 will be the carry because I have subtracted 16, not 8, next multiple of 8. That's why I have considered 2 as a carry. If you have memorized the table of equivalent numbers in all bases, you will find that 17 decimal is equal to 21 octal. So this is how we perform octal addition. Now let's see the practical examples, that is 2 number addition with carry. So I have arranged the equation in vertical manner. So let's have a adder here. 5602 is a adder and 4177 is a addend. And similar to the previous examples, this row will add the carry generated from previous operation. It will be added to the next addition. And here I will get the sum. So let's start with the sum of LSDs, that is 2 and 7. Now recall the procedure. 2 plus 7 is 9. It is greater than 7. So subtract 8 from the sum. So 9 minus 8 is equal to 1. So 1 will be the sum and 1 will be the carry. So sum 0 is 1, 1. And 1 is the sum and 1 is the carry. Now let's add the next digit. 0 plus 7 is equal to 7 and 7 plus 1 is equal to 8. Now 8 is again larger than 7. So subtract 8 from the result. What is the result over here? 8. So subtract 8 from 8. I will get 0. So my sum is 0 and carry is 1. See over here. My sum is 0 and carry is 1. So I will put sum as a 0 over here and 1 as a carry over here. Then perform this addition. 6 plus 1 plus 1. I will get 7. 7 plus 1 I will get 8. So again the result is larger than 7. So subtract 8 from 8. So again I will get 1, 0 as a sum over here. Now if you remember the table, if you have memorized the table, you will find that 8 in decimal is equal to 1, 0 in octal. That's why I am getting 1, 0. So 0 is a sum over here and 1 is the carry. Now perform the final addition. That is 5 plus 4 is equal to 9 plus 1 is equal to 10. That is in decimal. So subtract 8 from 10. I will get 2 as a sum over here and 1 as a carry. That means the result I will get is a 12 over here. So 2 is a sum, 1 is a carry. Now as there is no next digits, just put the carry as sum. So this is my final result. Now let's check the multi-number addition with carry. I have arranged the formula in vertical manner and I have 2 addends now here. Addend 1 and addend 2 along with carries. So let's start. I have considered a valid octal number with fractional part 675.4. So that octal addition of fractional numbers will also be clear to you. Let's consider the addend 1. It is 356.5 and I have considered the next addend as 275.3. I will add here the carry generated in previous operation. That will be placed here for next addition and I will get a sum over here. So now let's start with addition of fractional part, that is 4 plus 5 plus 3. I will call it as a sum 0. So 4 plus 5 is equal to 9 plus 3 is equal to 12. Again subtract 8 from 12. So I will get 4 as a sum and 1 as a carry. See over here. So I will put 4 over here as a sum and I will consider 1 as a carry. Now perform this next digit addition. 5 plus 6 is equal to 11 plus 5 is equal to 16 plus 1 is equal to 17. Now here subtract next multiple of 8, that is 16, because the result I am getting is more than 16. So here I will consider 2 as a carry because I am subtracting, I am taking out 16. So 1 will be the sum over here and 2 will be the carry. So 2, 1 is the result, 1 will be the sum and 2 is the carry. So now let's add next digits. 7 plus 5 is equal to 12 plus 7 is equal to 19 plus 2 is equal to 21. So subtract 16 over here. So 5 will be the sum over here and 2 will be the carry because we are subtracting 16, not 8. So 25 will be the result over here, and 5 is the sum, 2 is the carry for next digit addition. Now perform the final digit addition, that is 6 plus 3 plus 2 plus 2. So 6 plus 3 is 9, plus 2 is equal to 11, plus 2 is equal to 13. So now here this result is less than 16. So subtract 8, not 16. Here as I am taking out 8, so 1 will be the carry over here. So 13 minus 8 is 5. So 5 will be the sum over here, and 1 will be the carry. So my result is 15. So 5 will be the sum, and 1 is the carry for next digit addition. But as there are no next digits, we will put this carry as a sum. So this is how we perform octal addition. Now let's start with hex addition. So here again we have to follow the same procedure which we have seen in decimal, binary and octal addition. That means very first we will see two nibble addition, two digit addition, and the individual digit or individual symbol in hex number system is known as nibble. So we will first see two nibble addition. The basic formula we have is adder plus addend equal to, we get a sum. So now here as we are considering hex number system and we have two nibble addition, so 16 power 2 is equal to 256, such a possible combination is over here. So we will consider just few examples. So let's start with first example or first possibility. My adder is 0 over here and my addend is 1. Very basic thing. My sum should be a valid hex digit, that is a valid nibble. So here 0 plus 1 I will get 1, which is a valid hex nibble. So let's have a next possibility. Here I have considered 9 as a adder and 5 as a addend. So it will give me a sum of 9 plus 5 is equal to 14, and 14 decimal is equal to e in x. So the sum is e over here. So let's have one more possibility. Here I have considered 4 as a adder and 9 as a addend. So it will give me 4 plus 9 is equal to 13. 13 in decimal. So its hex equivalent is D. So I am getting D over here. Keep in mind, I should get the sum as a valid hex nibble. Let's have one more example. My adder is 9 over here and addend is 1. So it will give me 9 plus 1 is equal to 10, and 10 in decimal is equal to A in hex. So here I am getting A. Now here it is not mandatory that every time you will get a single digit sum. You may have a sum larger than 15. So what to do in that case? Let's check. We have one more concept, two nibble addition with carry. If carry is generated in previous operation, then we have to add the carry in current addition process. So what we will do here, we have adder and we will add it with addend along with carry generated in previous operation, and we will get sum over here. Now here again we have to perform 3 digit hex addition, that means 3 nibble addition. So 16 power 3 is 4098. Such possible combination is not possible for me to write here. So we will consider some possibilities. Here I have considered very basic possibility, that is adder is 0 and addend is 5 along with 0 carry. So 0 plus 5 is equal to 5, 5 plus 0 is equal to 5. So I will get a sum of 5 over here. Let's check with some advanced possibilities. Here 8 is the adder and 5 is the addend along with 1 as a carry. So it will give me a sum of how much? 8 plus 5 is equal to 13 plus 1 is equal to 14. That means 14 decimal is equal to e in x. So here I will get e as a sum over here. Let's have a next possibility. Here my adder is a and addend is b along with 1 carry. So now here it will give me a sum of how much it will give? A plus B. Now here consider decimal equivalent, because we cannot add letters here. So decimal equivalent of A is 10 and decimal equivalent of B is 11. So add these numbers. 10 plus 11 is equal to 21 plus 1 is equal to 22. So I should get 22 over here. I am getting 16. How my friend? Remembering the example we have seen in octal number system, I should have got the result 13, but I was getting 15. So same case here, we are considering decimal equivalent of A and B. So the addition I am getting in decimal, not in hex. So decimal equivalent of 22 is 16 if you know the table. Another method we have to get the result when the addition is larger than the highest possible digit in that number system, just subtract the base of that number system from the result and consider 1 as a carry over here. So see here, if these digits would have been decimal number system, then the result we will get is 22. So what we will do over here in decimal number system, we take out either 10 or multiples of 10 from the result to get a sum in digit, because the sum we are getting in number, 22 is a number, not a digit. So what we do over here to get a sum in the form of digit, we take out either 10 or multiples of 10 from the result, which is the larger one. Now here from the 22, 20 can also be subtracted. So we will subtract 20, not 10, and we will consider 2 as a carry, not 1, because we are subtracting 20, not 10. So here I am taking out 20, and that's why my carry will be 2 over here and my sum will be 2. So this is how we get 22. So now here we are considering these digits in hexadecimal number system. So here base is 16, not 10. So subtract 16 or multiples of 16 from the result to get the sum in a single digit. Subtract 16 from 22, I am getting 6. So here 6 is my sum, and 1 I will consider as a carry over here. This is how we will get a 16. So 6 is my sum over here, and this 1 has a carry for next addition. Getting the concept clear? Let's see some advanced examples. I have an adder as E and addend as F along with 2 as a carry. It will give me a sum of. Can you tell me now? The decimal equivalent of E is 14 and decimal equivalent of F is 15. So add 14 and 15, I will get 29 plus 2 carry, I will get 31. So now subtract either 16 or multiple, next multiple of 16, that is 32. We cannot subtract 32 from 31. So subtract 16 from 31 and consider it as a 1 carry. So when I subtract 16 from 31, I will get 15 as a remainder. So this 15 decimal is equal to F in hex. So I will get F as a sum over here and 1 as a carry. And that's why I am getting 1F as a result over here. Let's have some another example so that it will be more practice for you. So here my adder is F and my addend is C along with D as a carry. So now what it will give me? Consider the decimal equivalent of this hex digits. Decimal equivalent of F is 15, that of C is 12, and that of D is 13. So add 15, 12 and 13. What I will get? 40. Now subtract either 16 or multiples of 16. Now 32 I can subtract from here. So 32 subtracted from 40, I will get 8 as a sum over here and 2 as a carry. So easy. Now let's start with practical examples. So here I will have 2 number addition with carry, and I have arranged the equation in vertical manner. So let's consider the adder first. Here A6EF is the adder and C1B8 is the addend, and I will add the carry over here generated in previous operations. It will give me a sum over here. Let's start with the addition of LSD. So here F and 8 are the LSDs of adder and addend. So let's add this F and 8 first. We will consider it as a sum 0. So first consider decimal equivalent of F, that is 15. 15 plus 8 is 23. Now here the sum is larger than 15, that's why subtract the base of this number system from the result. So 16 subtracted from 23, I will get 7 as a sum over here and 1 as a carry. So here sum 0 as a 17. So put 7 as a sum over here and 1 as a carry. Now perform the next nibble addition, E plus B plus 1. So E is 14, B is 11. 14 plus 11 is 25 plus 1 is 26. Now the sum is larger than 15. So subtract 16 from the result. So 16 subtracted by 26, I will get 10 as a sum over here. 10 means A. So A will be the sum and 1 will be the carry. 1A will be the result over here. So place A as a sum over here and 1 as a carry. Now add the next nibble, that is 6 plus 1 plus 1, will get 8 over here. Now the result is less than 15, so no need to subtract 16 over here. So my sum will be 08 here. So just place the sum over here and there is no carry. So now add the next digit, A plus C. So decimal equivalent of A is 10 and decimal equivalent of C is 12. So 10 plus 12 is equal to 22. The result is larger than 15. So subtract 16 from 22. I will get 6 as a sum over here and 1 as a carry. Here I got 16 as a result over here, sum over here. So I will put 6 over here, and as there are no next digit to add, just I will put the carry as a sum. So this is how we add two hex numbers along with carry. Now let's move forward and let's see multi number addition with carry. So here I have arranged the equation in vertical manner. Here I have two addends, addend 1 and addend 2. You can have multiple addends. So here my adder is 6FE dot A and my addend is E5B dot C and my next addend is FB5.9. Here I will have carry generated from previous addition. I will add here. Here the carry for next addition will be put. And I will get a sum over here. So let's start with sum of fractional part. So here A plus C plus 9. Decimal equivalent of A is 10. That of C is 12. So 10 plus 12 is 22 plus 9 is 31. Now here the result is larger than 15. So subtract 16 from 31. So I will get 15 as a remainder. Hex equivalent of 15 is F. As I have subtracted 16, I will consider 1 as a carry. So my result will be 1F over here. So now here F is the sum of this addition and 1 is the carry for next addition. So I will put F over here and 1 is the carry for next nibble addition. So now just add this next nibbles. Decimal equivalent of E is 14 and that of B is 11. So 14 plus 11 is 25 plus 5 is 30 plus 1 is 31. Now here the result is again larger than 15. So subtract 16 from the result. So 31 minus 16 is 15 and the hex equivalent of 15 is F again. So here the sum will be F, and as I am subtracting 16, taking out 16, so carry will be 1. So my sum 1 will be 1F again. So I will put F as a sum over here and 1 as a carry for next nibble addition. Now add this next nibbles, F plus B plus F plus 5 plus B plus 1. So decimal equivalent of F is 15 plus 5 is 20 plus 11 is 31 plus 1 is 32. Now here next multiple of 16 is 32. We can subtract 32 from 32. So just subtract 32 from 32. We will get 0 as a sum over here, and as we are taking out 32, next multiple of 16, the carry will be 2. So my sum will be 20 over here. So I will put 0 as a sum here and 2 as a carry. Now add these MSDs or MSN, most significant nibbles. 6 plus E, that is 14. So 6 plus 14 is 20 plus F, that is 15. So 20 plus 15 is 35 plus 2 is 37. Now here again subtract 32, not 16. So if I subtract 32 from 37, I will get 5 as a sum over here and 2 as a carry. So my sum will be 25. So I will put 5 as a sum over here and 2 is the carry for next nibble addition. Now as there are no next nibbles, I will put 2 as a sum over here. This is how we can perform hex addition. So now we have seen addition in all number systems. So what will be our conclusion? Let's see. Our conclusion is that we add addend to the adder, and whatever result we get, we call it as a sum. The sum we get should be always in a digit. If the sum we get is in number, that is larger than the highest possible digit in that particular number system, then we subtract base or multiples of base from the result and we consider it as a carry. If we subtract the base from the result, we consider 1 as a carry. If we subtract next multiple of the base from the result, we consider 2 as a carry. If we subtract next to next multiples of the base, we consider 3 as a carry, and so on. And after subtracting whatever we get the difference, we call it as a sum for that particular addition. So this is how we perform additions in various number systems. I hope the concept of addition in all number systems is very much clear to you. If you have liked the video, press like button, share it to your friends, subscribe my channel Made Easy Solution, and press the bell icon to get the notification of future videos. Thank you.